Hello, everybody. Late at night, Mikey Garcia back from the gym. What a drive home.
I took the street because if I went through, I don't want to lose you.
You probably would have. So who's in the house right now?
It's just heavy right now.
That's it? Usually it's the...
Pitak will come in later.
Oh, you have that punch machine thing?
Yeah, check it out.
You know, a lot has changed when I came up the hill right now.
For the kids, for the little ones.
They play with it. I got the foosball.
That is a professional foosball. Who's the champion of foosball? Look at these belts. Mike, I remember when you had this, it had three belts in there.
Yeah.
What's here now?
We got the one smaller there, but...
There's more. You'll need another stand like this. Look at this. This is new.
Yeah.
And this... Mikey, this is, a lot of stuff are new here, Mike. This wasn't here last time.
I got more stuff in the other garage downstairs, too. Where all the cars at?
Which fight was that one? That's Robert Easter.
Yeah.
And this one?
That was Dijon.
And that one? It's Broner.
Yeah.
Which was your first belt here?
They're in order from bottom to top. 126 at the bottom.
126.
130. 35. Unified 35. 40. Diamond 40, that's a different
Fighter of the Year 2017 from ESPN.
Knockout of the Year,
and what was that one?
That's Garcia Promotions.
Garcia Promotion. Well, like I said, you need more stands.
Yeah, I got more.
Where's the new dog? How many cars you got? Mikey Garcia has a car collection. Check this out. How do you know which key goes with which car?
It's,
you know? Dejan.
Yep.
This is a special device to lock your guns so nobody can steal your guns. Cool, Mikey. So your life is good? You've been working hard?
Yeah, working hard. Staying hungry. You gotta stay hungry.
Where's your newest dog, the puppy?
It's over here by Hector's. I'll show you.
Alright. Is she allowed in or no?
I had her inside, but right now I have her outside.
She's grown.
See you in a vez.
What's up, chef? Haven't seen you in a minute.
You gonna get some dinner with me?
Yeah, we're gonna go get some dinner. We're doing a new segment here on EsNews.
We're gonna eat some dinner here. Tell him that I'm gonna eat dinner.
Okay. We won't. Yeah, he wasn't getting offended. But he's a real chef. He's dressed and everything.
He's a real deal. He's just going to make us some dinner right now. But then we're going to go take the guys to dinner.
Mikey, we're doing a new segment here. It's called In Your Corner, 24 Hours in a Day of a Fighter. And we're starting with you, Mikey Garcia, 24 Hours in Your Life. So what will fans see?
Started today at the gym at 4.
Mm-hmm.
All right, 24 hours. Of
24 hours.
Gotcha.
Everything, look, when I drove up the mountain this time, the road looked paved, a lot of properties for sale, a lot of changes
there's a little bit of development. So they got the new road is paved, the main road down to the canyon is getting repaved just in time before the winter and the mud and then the flooding, because it's always something happens every year. So they're taking care of that. Some of the properties have been starting to go for sale, go on the market. So.
There was one pothole, but it was way back when. I just ran over it on the way here. And the first row, after the stop sign?
Now they're starting to... They went up to the stop sign.
Yeah.
Now they're going further to the beginning of the road. Yep.
So the chef knows you're coming. He's very professional. Yeah. Food is ready.
He'll be ready right away. He gets things done. I like Hector. He's very professional. Takes care of business,
So normally, if you had a fight date, what would your life, a day in the life of Mikey be like? If there was a fight, let's say you're fighting.
If I had a full training camp, I would probably have, sometimes I'd have a sparring partner here too. I'd have a bigger team. Pita would definitely be here. Rafa has been here. I'll have other guys stay to help with, just things around the house, around boxing. Right now, because there is no official date, I started to... He's been here... Héctor.
¿Dónde?
¿Cuántas semanas llevas aquí ya?
Fui para siete. Seven. Tengo seis.
So he's 6 weeks here because we were planning on fighting him in December.
So,
I brought him over for that reason, but things have changed a little bit, so, I mean, he's going to go home after this week.
For Christmas, the holidays, New Year's.
After Saturday, he goes home. Then they spend a whole week over there, and then it depends on how my schedule goes, he'll be ready to come back. He asked me, you know, some time, because he's been out here for, you know, 6 weeks. And if I don't have an exact date or anything, you know, I let him go. Then he'll probably go back for Christmas, or he said if I'm training, he might bring his family here for a few days for Christmas.
There's room, you have a guest house downstairs, right? Yeah. Like the whole complex. It's like a hotel, the motel, Bates Motel down there.
Bates Motel.
It looks like.
Yeah, we got the other home, 3 bedrooms.
Brand new.
Bath, full kitchen, so it's good. If I don't have my sparring partners there, you know, he can stay there. I've had other people stay there too.
Do you still have a lot of chickens and roosters and stuff? Or?
There's a few things out there, but I'm not growing anything. I'm not raising anything because this is more maintenance. There's a few. My gardener, Blas, he has a couple of chickens out there.
How's he doing, by the way?
He's good.
He's always missing for 5 days, 4 days, 3 days. Then he pops up again.
He'll pop up. Yeah, he tends to do that.
I heard he flipped over with the quad, right?
Once.
Is he okay?
It's fine.
No helmets, right?
Yeah, we had helmets.
Oh, okay, that's good.
Yeah, helmets. Yeah, we had our helmets. We were test driving basically the Can-Am. And I'm hauling ass in it, and I was drifting it, and I caught some sand that just made us flip.
So, and good thing nothing happened.
We had our harness, helmets, everything. Nothing happened.
That's a good frame. When you came home right now, the dogs were going crazy. Is that the welcoming you always get? That you always get really excited?
Always.
The new dog, male or female?
Female.
And she's fighting with the males?
No, the thing is that my pit bull fights the German Shepherd.
Oh, okay. So you have a pit bull too,
yeah,
besides the new one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I've had a pit bull before.
Yeah.
I don't keep them saying, I separate them because my pit bull fights keep us German Shepherds. The guy in fights.
All the time.
So I separated them now.
Well, he's protecting the back of the house.
Yeah, they're protecting the back, and the German Shepherd protects the front. So I got my dogs in the back.
But I will tell people, don't beware of the dogs, beware of the owner.
It's not the dogs that you should be fearing. you don't have to fear anything.
So, I forgot to tell you. Tyler, who works with me, he did an interview with Eddie Hearn over the weekend, and Eddie said, I'm still trying to sign Mikey.
Well, I mean, we've always had conversations. We've had conversations. We look into options to you know, maybe work. We just haven't got to that point, but every time that he's out here, he tries to, you know, talk to me or, you know, sit down and talk about possible, you know, fights and stuff, but until he comes with something, you know, that really, really excites me, and something that makes me excited for not only financially, but fights, certain fights that can excite me, then, you know, at that point, we'll definitely consider and look into and explore more, but until then, you know, I'm doing it all on my own.
That's true. So far, your boxing career has been really like a movie. Mm-hmm. From when you started an amateur show, when you, Pelos, your nephew, just passed away. You saw him, and they asked if you want to fight too. You stepped in there and won, and you liked it.
Yeah, it started with I was 13 years old, and Pelos was, I mean, he's a year younger, so he was 12. Yeah, and he started boxing, and they had an amateur show in Reseda. And we went, me and my brother, my family, we went to support him, like just to cheer him on. But there was one kid from the other gym there that didn't have an opponent, and Robert just signed me up.
And you never boxed before? You never trained either? Nothing?
We played around at the home, you know.
Yeah, but now I'm talking about like training 6 months, 3 months.
no training.
And you made weight too?
Well, we were the same weight. Cause
your kids?
Yeah. I was 13, he was 15. But similar way, I was like 126, he was like 124.
But 15 to 13 is a big difference. 15-year-olds are more...
I was 15, I was 13.
So what happened?
But I was a little heavier, so I was like 126, he was like 124, 123, something like that. I remember he kind of evened out.
Okay, you know? So you step in the ring with him first time. No butterflies, nothing?
Well, I just said, all right, let's do it. So I get in the ring, and it was an exhibition. Because I was not licensed to compete, yeah. So they had to make it just like a sparring session, an exhibition. So we did. It was fun. And that's when I did. After that, I decided to go to the gym and work out and train, learn, you know.
And then you started fighting. It took you years. You won the first title.
I trained for a few months before I did my first amateur. So I was 13. Like, I still clearly remember. It was like in September of the year when I was 13. And then in February, once I turned 14, I turned 14 in December. So, you know, September to February, about 6 months or whatever, I did my first amateur fight. And I fought a kid who, I think at the time, he had like 10 fights or something like that. And we fought in Commerce.
Usually it's...
Hawaiian Gardens. It's Hawaiian Gardens.
Usually the open is only after 5 fights, right?
10
fights. Okay, but you still fought him on your first. What's for dinner?
Starting off with a little soup.
Onion soup.
Just a little veggie soup.
Good for you. Yeah, he brought you some lemons. No, thank you. I'm good. I just ate.
You can get some.
No, I'm okay. Thank you.
No,
I'm good. Thanks. I appreciate it.
What's wrong with this, Ellie?
Nothing. I'm working.
But what's wrong with
this? It looks amazing.
What
I got to know what's in it. I got to know the ingredients.
It's onion?
Correct.
Onion.
He doesn't put any chicken broth or, you know, sometimes they put powder of... Okay. No, but I'm good.
¿Cómo preparas este tipo de caldito? ¿Qué le pones? Porque quiere saber para si lo quiere probar él. Él sabe que es un...
Es que coso carne aparte.
Okay.
Hago el caldo de carne.
Okay.
Am I right? You see? No, it's okay. It's normal. Yeah, yeah.
He cooks the broth separate.
Ajá. And then he... más frío lo que es con poquito de este olivo, la cebolla, poquito de orégano, y ya nomás el caldo de la carne, y ya...
Who Who has your chef to work with so far, from the names?
¿Quién has trabajado tú?
Hay canales, tenemos...
¿Chávez?
He trabajado con más de 14 campeones del mundo, si no me acuerdo, 15.
14, 15 world.
That's a lot. Like who?
He trabajado... Pues empecé trabajando con José Luis Castillo.
José Luis Castillo, started with him.
Trabajé... Travieso Arce, trabajé Cocho Montiel, trabajé Tyson Marquez, trabajé... Brandon Ríos, Gamboa, Félix Díaz, Amir Khan, ¿quién más me falta?
Chávez Jr.
And Mikey, ¿quién más? Chino Maidana.
What do you think? Chávez Jr., Danny Jacobs, what do you think?
Si entrena bien Chávez Jr. Gana.
He's going to win?
Yes. Trains well, he will win.
Yeah. Gamboa and Tank, Gervonta Davis Gamboa.
Tank.
¿Por qué?
Es más rápido, más fuerte ya Gamboa.
Easy
ya
work.
Está, ya está grande, ya está. Y Tank está en su momento.
Tank's in his prime. Gamboa's past his prime.
Does every fighter eat the same or do some fighters different food?
No, es diferente. Es diferente, depende del peso que traigan. ¿Y me explico?
Different depending on the weight and what they got to cut to.
Did you ever cook any frogs?
Has cocinado ranas.
No, nunca. Las he probado, no las he cocinado.
Is it good? Does it taste like chicken?
Sí, muy bueno, sabe a pollo.
That's the old joke. What did the one lesbian frog tell the other lesbian frogs? It's true what they say, you do taste like chicken. Never mind, I have to cut that out.